All right, so today, here's what we got. We got a 2015 here with 115,000 miles on it. Customer says, I've got to add coolant every other day or so. It's going through a lot of coolant. So I pressure tested up the cooling system. I have no visible external leaks anywhere. And as you guys know, I like to pull out this sensor, take a look. Now, what you're gonna notice is how clean and polished that thing is. So along with it being clean and polished, you'll also see that we have a little bit of wetness right there in the threads. And if you look up inside of there, can't really see it on the camera so well, but it is nice and clean inside of that EGR bypass tube. All of that coolant is coming from that EGR cooler right there. So I'm gonna get this cooler off of here, get it pulled out, show you what we got going on, and we're gonna discuss a couple things about it. So stay tuned. Alrighty guys, got the cooler off. I want you to see this. So I don't know if the camera's gonna pick it up so well, but you see all those droplets in there and all across the face of that? This EGR cooler has been leaking pretty good. Let me show you the other end because it's actually really clean and wet as a result. You see a little bit of soot and stuff build up in there, but it's really clean. This thing's been cleaning itself, steaming itself with coolant. So with it, of course, leaking pretty severely internally, we're gonna put another EGR cooler back on here for this guy, but I'm gonna take this minute to talk about some of the other parts that we have available to us. Now, you've seen me do the Bulletproof Diesel water pump, and that thing's phenomenal. Well, they've also got an EGR cooler. So for the people who are gonna continue to run their emissions control devices on here, thank you for that. But you want to make sure that you're putting on quality products, you can go with a Bulletproof Diesel EGR cooler and save yourself a little bit of money over what the factory one is. But it's also manufactured differently. It doesn't have the same style of cooling fins on the inside. In fact, theirs is designed to where it doesn't fail on fatigue due to the hot and cold cycles that these things are put under. But in this case right here, we need to get this guy back on the road. We can't actively sell those aftermarket parts here. I work at a dealership, so we have brand loyalty that we have to fall under. But for those of you who are out there watching me right now, know that there is another option besides the factory EGR cooler to go back on here. Get a hold of Bulletproof Diesel and get you one of their Bulletproof EGR coolers. I'm excited for the first one that I get to put on, so maybe one of you guys wants to go buy one, bring it over to me. Let me throw that thing on there for you. But in the meantime, we're gonna get a factory one put back on here for the guy, get him back on the road. It's coming up on Memorial Day weekend, so everybody wants their truck back so they can go camping and all that good stuff. But anyway, I'm gonna cut this off now and let you guys get back to it. But you know, hit the like, comment, share, all of that good stuff on there, and you know, drop me a comment. Let me know what you think. Anyway, peace.